Ryan, enter. Come on in, hurry up.
Take a seat, please, students, quickly and quietly.
Love school.
Yeah, I know you're getting some flashbacks, Ryan.
Oh. Welcome, students, to Jungle School, where our motto is education through discomfort. Unfortunately, the entire student body and teaching faculty are off sick today. So six of you will be our substitutes.
Now, students, normally at school, good behaviour is rewarded with gold stars. And at this school, it's no different. In fact, all up, there are 12 gold stars up for grabs, which means 12 possible meals for camp.
Calm down,
Essex. Please.
I need a lesson on how to do that.
Yeah, less wrist work in class, please.
Sorry.
Each of your lessons will be assessed by an expert in their field, watching proceedings via video link direct from the staff room. Now, students, this school is what you might refer to as, well, experimental. We don't believe in the three R's of reading, writing and arithmetic.
Yes.
Instead, we're big on the three S's.
Yes.
Short, sharp, shocks.
That is unethical. So to stimulate your interest in education, you are going to be wired up to electrodes.
No way.
Now, our first subject today is art. And your teachers will be Poe and Dylan.
Come on. The best.
Celebrities. Get ready for some high voltage learning here at
the School of Shock. Now, students, your class is ready to be educated.
Over to you guys.
Thank you.
Hello, class. Welcome to art. Well, we paint a bowl of fruit. We call this a still life. Dylan, please show the class how to be still. Okay, painting time. Dylan, I'd like some brown on my palette, please.
I've got so many questions.
Thank you. Now, brush technique!
Don't spill, Poe.
It's often an individual choice, but personally... I like to paint in a crisscross motion! Like so.
Oh, that's power.
Maybe.
She did say she was trained.
She did say this is her other thing.
That bowl is looking marvellous, isn't it? Now for the fruit. I find it's always best to paint fruit in alphabetical order.
Okay.
Nice red.
That's beautiful.
Oh, lovely touch.
That's a great apple.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Beautiful. Swap places.
Oh, I like it.
The only fruit named after a colour. Some orange, please, Poe.
You can do this. Come on.
The jus d'orange.
The measure.
Yes, I like it. Oh, that's nice.
And looks like a mango.
It's a weird style.
I don't know about you guys, but when I paint an orange, I like to sing the orange song. Oranges are lovely, they are orange. Oranges are my favourite fruit. I get my vitamin C, vitamin D from orange. Last but never least is my old friend, the banana. Some yellow green.
This is a great banana.
That's a good one.
That is
a beautiful banana.
That is a banana.
The plant game.
Well, That is a great banana.
That's a great banana.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. That was going so well.
Professor Percival Pallet said that it's a 3.5-star effort.
Oh, very nice.
Amazing.
All right, celebrities, there are 4 more stars up for grabs right now, with David and Emily teaching home economics.
Hello, class. This is home economics. Today, we'll be learning how to make a lemon cheesecake cream pie.
Make this dessert. We need these 8 ingredients, lots of love and a dish.
The crust. We place our shortbread in a Ziploc bag and turn everything into crumbs. Emily, could you please demonstrate?
She feels it, doesn't she?
I don't want to do it.
Whoa, they are crumbs.
Next, place your crumbs in a large bowl. Make sure you mix slowly and smoothly. Emily, would you like to please demonstrate?
I would love to. I'm going down.
You can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Well done, Emily. You are a master baker.
Thanks, David. Now for the lemon cream filling.
How do you do it, Poe?
Remember to keep the bowl as steady as you whisk.
Yes.
Now tip the mixture onto the crust.
Oh, look out. Right.
Finally, David, show the class how to decorate your dessert with some whipped cream. There you have it. Lemon cheesecake cream pie, or something vaguely resembling it. Doesn't it look simply mouthwatering? Thanks, class.
Come on!
Yes!
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 They are being awarded 3 stars out of potential 4. Very nice.
That's awesome.
There we go.
They're all great.
You guys are so naughty.
That's so good.
Mr. Essex, sit down, please.
Detention.
You are a very bad boy.
Do not
make Miss Morris punish you.
Oh, man. To earn 4 stars today, you will be teaching science.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Oh.
That's how it goes. Yay. Yay.
Buckley.
There you go.
Great. Different style.
Today we'll be conducting a simple inquiry into density. Did you know that eggs will float in salted water and sink in non-salted water?
Wow.
Cal, the students might not be familiar with eggs. Could you show them what they are, please?
Not so well done.
All right, Cal, could you please very carefully fill each of our glasses with the water?
Yep, good job.
That's my goodness. I mean, electricity and water.
Okay.
It's
foolish.
You're doing beautifully.
Not a drop spill.
Yeah.
Now we need to increase the liquid's buoyancy. So Nathan, I'd like you to add 2 tablespoons. You to add 2 tablespoons of salt to the second and fourth glasses.
Yeah. No. Oh my God, that's so good.
Or the second. Oh, don't spill the salt, huh? It's bad luck.
Now, Nathan, we're going to place an egg in the first and third glasses where the water without salt is less buoyant.
Here we go.
Oh dear. Oh, you're doing it. Sinks there. Hey, he's got the skill.
As you can see, the eggs have sunk, not unlike my dignity. Okay, now let's add an egg to the salt water and see what happens.
Here we go, into the salt.
This one's going.
Oh.
And something is
here.
What's happening?
Mrs. Cow, Mrs. Cow. Why is it not doing anything?
Oh, look, Nathan's is.
Oh, Mr. Nathan. Have luck, please.
Class, and there you have it. The eggs do not sink. Why? Because of science. Thank you, class. Oh,
yeah. I love this.
Very nice. Superb uses of science equipment.
Yes. But ultimately, a disappointing scientific result.
Two stars.
Wow.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's fine.
That is 8.5 stars, guys, which is a pretty fabulous total.
That's
well done. Doctor, you actually don't look too impressed, my lover.
Well, you know, just kind of lack the science, to be honest.
Oh, not science-y enough. Are you suggesting you could do better, Doctor?
Absolutely. Bet your beaker I can, Julia.
Bet my what? All right, my beloved Einstein, take it away.
Today, we're going to be making elephant toothpaste. Now, before I begin, for any youngsters watching, this is a highly dangerous experiment, so do not try this at home, OK? All we do is just add... Elephants are very particular about the colour of their toothpaste, so that goes into there, into the hydrogen peroxide. Then we get some potassium iodide. Are we following there, Ryan?
Yeah, I got it.
Goes into there, then we'll just get a little bit of this sodium solution into this little beaker here. We're going to mix that around nice and gently. There we go. We're keeping up here, Essex.
Interesting, yeah.
Mix that around there. Mix this in here, and we'll get that in there, and then...
Jesus! Yeah. Yeah. That was sick.
And that is how you do science. Well done.
Bye,
hon. See? Yeah, we had a good time, didn't we?
Huh? Well done.
Oh, darling.
Well done.
Good stuff.
That was...
Thanks, baby. Close the door.
You did a terrific job, sir.
I certainly did.
Oh, now, Doctor, surely we should be punishing them for all that food they stole.
Patience, little one.